Hey guys. So welcome back to the channel. It's been a while. I'm currently away for work, so this is not my house. I just thought I'd preface this video. It is quite short. I didn't get the off-road footage that I would have liked. I did get to drive on a few dirt roads just to feel how it was comfort-wise, but I do definitely want to do a little bit more actual forward driving with technical tracks and things like that. Life gets in the way. And I hope you guys enjoy the video. And there is a sink in my room. That is a thing. Okay, bye. Alrighty, hey guys, welcome back to the YouTube channel. I am filming outside, so I'm definitely gonna have to stop for trucks every 5 minutes, but that's okay, we'll get through this. Mars is here, so. So I just finished work. I found out I'm probably going away for 5 weeks very shortly. Stick with me, but it should just be a little bit up and down, which is pretty much normal for my channel anyway. Anybody who has been following for a very long time knows that my springs have been in there since the dawn of time, and probably long before the dawn of time. I bought the car in 2011, so for the last 11 years, it has had these springs. I've had them hot reset. We've mucked around with them, removed retainers. Anyway, they're really old. So I bought the car with 5 years of receipts. Their suspension wasn't on there, so either they didn't include it in the receipts or it was done longer than 15, 16 years ago. Old. One of the most asked questions after what mud flaps do you have and where'd you get them is, how do you get your car to flex? How do you get leaves to flex? What's your suspension kit? I'm gonna let you guys in on a little secret. The suspension in this car is not that good. The flex is not that impressive. It does look like a lot because compared to a lot of 75s, it does all right, holds its own. But in terms of actual travel of a wheel, it's got pretty standard amount of travel. A lot of people compare the front of mine to a 79 front. The 6-cylinder 79s and the V8s obviously went to coil front. When you lift and you put longer springs in a coil, obviously they can't compact as much. Like, think of a slinky. The longer the slinky, the bigger it is when it's compressed. So the wheel doesn't tuck up as much in lifted coil fronts. Also, you've got things like your radius arm bind and panhard bind and just a heap of arms that I obviously don't have. So a leaf's pretty simple. It lets my wheel go right up into the guard, and that makes people think it looks sick. I don't know. It does like look a lot more, I guess, hectic than what a coil front would. Now the sprinklers are on. Yay. I don't know if you guys know this, but these cars, before social media existed, were actually purchased to do work. And some of them still are, but yeah, that's what they are made to do. So a lot of the kits are made to carry weight, not flex off-road. You'll find a lot of the pre-made kits and the off-the-shelf leaf packs are made to carry a heavy load, which means they don't have as much articulation in them as what mine have, because they're really, really light springs that are in mine. There's only 7 in each pack. When I bought the car, it had 12 leafs in each pack. It was made for load. So when you have those big multi-leaf packs, it's made to pretty much stay exactly where it is, no matter what load's on it. So when you articulate off-road, you, like, getting on a weird angle or falling into a hole is not enough to actually compress that spring and overcome the spring rate, if that makes sense. So it stops your wheel from, I guess, traveling up, which on a solid axle car kind of limits the other wheel from doing anything as well. So you end up with the whole car, you know, no flex. Because there's so many leaves in the pack, there's a lot of, I guess, helper leaves down the bottom. It also stops the leaf from cambering and your wheel traveling down. So you don't have up travel, you don't have down travel, but you can carry a shit ton of stuff. So yeah. That was a really basic overview of how leaf spring works. There's a lot more to it and it gets a lot more complicated, but basically that's what it does. There's only so many things that will stop your car from flexing or articulating off-road. One is the wheel traveling up, hitting something and not going any further. Two, it hasn't got enough length in either the shock, the spring, the sway bars, anything for it to keep traveling down. That's pretty much it. When I had leafs removed out of my packs and then I had them hot reset back to 2 inches, it allowed them to move a lot more. also the fact that they're super old. So all the retainers on the leaf packs have a little bit of extra movement. They're all kind of bent, they're all worn out. Everything can just move that little bit more. So when people are like, oh, how do you get it? It's like to flex so much. And it's like, well, just, you know, leave your springs for 15 years and they'll be pretty smudgy. The downsides to that and why I needed to change is because they're really old, they're really noisy, like clonking when you turn or put weight, they make noises like an old man. Sanded them and repainted them, and obviously between the leaf packs is I can't get to, and they rub and leak rusty water out every time I wash the car. And I don't know, it's just little things like that, but mainly just they're old. Look at this Nigel. That brings us to this video. I've been in contact with Terrain Tamer for a while now. I'm installing a few other parts of theirs that I've had for ages that I need to put in. Terrain Tamer came to me and they were like, hey, we've got a parabolic kit coming out for the 75 series. So they have them for the 79s. We've installed them in other people's cars before. I respect parabolics. I don't value comfort that much. It's a leaf spring. Look, it's never gonna be a coil car, so eh. They were like, hey, do you wanna try this suspension kit? And I was like, look, I don't really know. I love my springs, and I was like, why would I change? Because I know that, like, I just can't buy 15-year-old springs to get the same kind of movability here. So when Terrain Tamer were like, just try it. If you don't like it, that's all good. No stress. Let us know what you don't like, what you do like, but we think you're gonna like it. And I'm like, okay, but I don't think I am. I was like the kid who thought they knew everything and the mum being like, well, just try it, okay, and see how you go. And then you have a great time and you've got to like be like, okay, you were right. So that's exactly what happened. So yeah, I had my doubts, had massive doubts, made those doubts very clear to Terrain Tamer. But anyway, put the kit in. Kit comes with everything. Comes with your four shocks, four parabolic springs. They're 0 to 500 kilo rated, which is insane. If you've ever ridden on a multi-leaf up to 500 kilos, you know how rough it is. So for this to be able to handle that amount of weight, crazy. I will let you guys know as well, this kit is available online and the link for it will be in the description. This is not a sponsored video of any kind. Obviously, I want to travel on it a heap more. I want to fluctuate the weight a heap more. So yeah, I probably will put the Domitson remote res back in because for corrugations and things like that. And I've driven on overheated shocks before and it's not fun. Terrain Tamer also do a remote res adjustable shock as well. So there's that option. But yeah, very impressed with the overall ride quality. I've been driving it to work, going over all the speed bumps and potholes I can find, and it drives very similar to how my old springs did, so that's pretty impressive. This road is sloped down, but yeah, you can see that it sits really nice. Just got our standard shackles. I probably would have liked to go on a anti-inversion, and I think the kit actually does come with an anti-inversion. But yeah, this leaf pack I can lift up with one hand, comfortably with one hand. So I've definitely lost a heap of weight across the whole car with these leaf packs. Okay, hey guys, so my camera actually fell off my car yesterday, but I downloaded all the files last night. Turns out it's just the display, so we're gonna power on, and hopefully this video turns out fine. Okay, so this is all my old suspension. I do wanna do just a really good review of the shocks that come with the Terrain Tamer kit, so that, you know, like not everybody needs remote res. So you can see what I mean by the discoloration. These are the super old bushes, which you can see are oblong, not round anymore. what I could do in. Okay, my vacuum cleaner is going, so that's what that noise is. So the front's always been about 1300 kilo. When I first got the canopy done, it was 2.9. But adding the awning, the fridge, I've added a 20 kilo water jerry on the back. But yeah, the new suspension's obviously a heap lighter, so the front axle weights came down a heap. Overall, the car's sitting about 240 kilos lighter, which is awesome. Doesn't that just look crazy how there's only two leaf?
I love weight saving at the moment. That is what I care about. Anything that I can get to be lighter is awesome.
Okay, so I was going to actually try and go off-road and show you guys the articulation. The spot I normally go in is just like an absolute swamp. Like, it's had water sitting there for so long, it's like green and mossy, and I'm just like, no, no. So instead, I got the Marzi boy. Wait there. Wait. And we're going to go run in this big open field. Okay. Where are we, Marzi? Where are we? Okay guys, thank you very much for watching this video. It was just a short one because I have a lot more kilometers to do on these springs before sort of giving a final overview, but so far very impressed. Like this video, please leave a comment. I love reading your comments. I've lost my dog. Maz, what are you doing? Come here. Come here. Come up here. If you're not subscribed already, I would love it if you could. It's an amazing way to show your support for the channel. The next video will be the 76 suspension, which is actually what this camera is sitting on. Don't tell Jay. Yeah. So yes, I'll run you through the suspension that is in the 76 in the next video. It's very nice. It's much comfier than the 75. Open up my heart and you'll find you don't ever have to look too far. You don't have to cover up your scars.